So, with the M2 chips now out, everyone wants to know when the successor to the M1 iMac 24-inch will be coming, and that is the new M2 iMac 24-inch model. And what features will it have? Well, we've been told that it might be having an M2 and an M2 Pro inside this time around, what is super exciting. So today I want to go over specs, design, really everything we know so far for the new iMac M2, and of course I want to go over the iMac 2022 release date and price as well. But first, a quick summary of where we are with the iMac. So Apple updated the only remaining iMac in 2021 with a whole new design with a 24.5 inch display with the M1 chipset inside. The design is the thinnest iMac that has ever been created, and it's gone back to its old late 90s roots of adding lots of color choices that you can pick from. The iMac is a great home PC Mac for anyone who needs to browse the web or do some amateur photo, music or video editing, as the M1 chipset can more than cope with these tasks on an ad hoc basis. Well, we have some more great news, and that Apple are looking to enhance the new design iMac with a couple of new features, and of course putting the next generation M2 chipset inside, what has just been announced at WWDC. So with that M2 journey, what has now begun with the M2 MacBook Pro and that brand new design MacBook Air with an M2 inside coming, the M2 chipset offers us around about 18% more CPU performance than we had on the M1. But for GPU, we're gaining up to 35% more power when you pick that new 10-core GPU option. As you can imagine, it's logical for Apple to apply this chipset into their remaining Macs and devices that have an M1 chipset already. So I'm talking about the iMac 24-inch, Mac Mini, iPad Pro, and of course the iPad Air. But remember, all of these devices may take a year or even a bit more to get the upgrades to M2, especially with the iPad Air, as that was the last device to get the M1 chipset, and that was only a few months ago. It's more than likely that the next devices to get the M2 chipset will be the iPad Pro, Mac Mini, and the iMac. So for the iMac M2, we've had some big news just come in that we could be in fact getting the M2 Pro chipset along with the M2 chipset. According to Jeff Pugh, the M2 Pro is expected to be ready for the end of this year in new devices, and to be honest, it makes sense for the iMac to have this chipset. Remember, right now the replacement for the 27-inch iMac is the Mac Studio, and you can pick either an M1 Max or an M1 Ultra inside. The current iMac only offers the M1 chipset, so there is no desktop that offers an M1 Pro. However, this is most likely going to change with the iMac 24-inch offering an M2 and M2 Pro, where the next generation Mac Studio will offer the M2 Max and the M2 Ultra. But with all of this, a quick note, with any of these leaks, even up to the new iMac release date, with all these reports and leaks, they're not 100% proof that they will come true with the new iMac. I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is being said about the next iMac anyway. So, just quickly guys, this channel recently got over 350,000 subscribers, what's absolutely amazing. So in celebration of this, I am doing a giveaway right now on this channel for this. It is for a MacBook Air, and this MacBook Air here is the 8-core GPU option with 512 gigabytes of storage, and I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 400,000 subscribers. And all you need to do to enter into this international giveaway is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear or what technology gear you're planning to buy in 2022. And when we get over that 400,000 subscribers marker, I'll be creating a video on this channel announcing who the winner is. So if you are new here, make sure to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell right now. Now, just quickly, I do want to mention there are lots of scammers, there are lots of spammers, a lot of them impersonating myself, and they're telling you to WhatsApp you or to WhatsApp them or to Telegram them. Ignore them completely or report them, because this is not me. Like you've heard from me here, I'll be making a video when we get over 400,000 subscribers announcing any kind of giveaway on this channel, and it will definitely be this time for this MacBook Air here. Well, with that out of the way guys, let's return back to the video. So, release date's next, and as the M1 journey in all Macs is complete and we now have started the M2 journey with the new MacBook Pro and that new design MacBook Air, the next devices to be upgraded from the Macs is going to be the iMac and the Mac Mini. As Apple already started a journey similar to the M1, it's likely these are the next devices to be updated to an M2 chipset. Apple will normally hold an event in September time that is more primarily for Apple's watches, iPads, and also the iPhones. However, we normally get another event around mid to end October time showcasing the new Macs that come out around about the end of October to early November time. It's expected for Apple to release the new M2 Macs at this time. So, with that out of the way, let's talk about the iMac specs along with the price. So starting out, as already mentioned, the actual design is probably going to be staying the same for the iMac, just like we had with the M1 iMac that came out in 2021. But this basically means we'll be getting that same 23.5 inch LED Retina display, what we basically call is a 24 inch display. And the resolution of the display is a 4480 by 2520. This is a standard LED Retina display. It's not a mini LED display like in what we get in, say, the MacBook Pro, the 14 inch and 16 inch, and also that 12.9 inch iPad. So it's not going to be that. It's the same display as we've had before. But the great news is the pixels per inch will be 218. We'll have storage options between 256 gigabytes all the way up to 2 terabytes, depending on what kind of configuration that you pick. But the actual chipset inside it will be that brand new M2 8-core CPU, what is made up of 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores, and then you will also get the GPU, what will be up to 10 cores this time, 10 graphical cores, up from the up to 8 cores that we used to get in the M1 chipset. We will also get the choice between of 8GB or 16GB of RAM again, and the actual body will be an aluminium body, and then on the back we will have ports of either a choice of 2 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, or if you go for a higher configuration you will get the 2x USB-C ports, what are USB 3, and you will also get those 2x Thunderbolt 4 ports, and you will also get a 1 gigabit Ethernet port, what's actually built into the power block, what you can like stick on the floor, for example. The colors will basically be the same again, and Apple could introduce a new color this year, so we'll have to wait and see on that. But the colors as they stand right now is blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange, and purple. But like I said, they could introduce a whole new color, so we have to wait and see on that one. For the webcam, there's going to be a slight upgrade here. We're going to be getting a 1080p center stage camera now, because we do have the M1 chipset inside it and it can kind of handle sort of image processing bits and pieces. It makes sense for this to be upgraded to this. With price though, starting out with an 8GB of RAM configuration, and this is the lower spec M2 chipset, if you chose 256 gigabytes of storage, this will come in at $1,299 US, and then 512 gigabytes will be $1,499 US, and then for example 1 terabyte would be $1,699 US. So as you can see, Apple built the foundations of the M1 iMac and made it better here with the M2 iMac. So next are my wishes for the iMac M2, and really it's to do with the price. Right now the M1 iMac starts at $1,299 US, but I fear that Apple may actually increase the price this year by putting that M2 chipset inside it. I really hope they don't do this. They might slap on an extra $100 US, but I'm really hoping that the starting price will remain the same at $1,299 US and it shouldn't increase at all. But those are my thoughts and wishes. Do you agree with that? Let me know in the comments below, because I'd love to know your thoughts. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to press the like button, and at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, make sure you hit the subscribe button followed by that notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you really soon.